Hi friends, welcome to Ajay Divedi's SQL Server classes. Today we are going to see how to create a virtual machine on VMWare Workstation. So I hope that you have already downloaded VMWare Workstation. To start with, we first make sure that we are saving our virtual machines on a specific location of our choice. You can do that by resetting the preferences. Go to edit and then preferences. So here you should modify this URL path for all the virtual machines. Apart from this, you can even modify the memory settings here. Whatever memory value in MBs you provide here, your all virtual machines in combined would be able to use this much memory only. So I think we are good with the normal settings. Let's proceed. In order to create a virtual machine, we simply need to select this My Computer, then File, New Virtual Machine. Select the custom option here, then press Next. Browse a image that you want to install. Say that you want to install Windows 10, then you can choose image for Windows 10. In my case, I would like to install operating system later, so I would choose this option. Next, you can choose what kind of operating system will it have. So let's say that I am going to install Windows 10 64-bit edition, so here it is. Now, this would be the virtual machines that you will see here, like in my cases. In my case, I have already installed DC, SQL A, SQL B. So those names, this is the screen where you provide those names. So in my case, let's say I am going to give it a name, end user, SQL end user. And if you remember, this was the path that I set in preferences under edit menu. So keep the firmware setting same. Here you can allocate the CPU according to your need. In my case, I generally prefer 2x2. And then here you can specify how much memory you want to allocate for this virtual machine. In my case, I prefer 2GB. Yeah, so getting to the network type, there are variety of network types supported by each of the virtualization softwares available in market, but few of them are very common, like you will always see host only networking, host only adapter in each of the virtualization software. Similarly, you will see NAT, network address translation, and bridged adapter. If you wish to create a SQL Server lab or any other kinds of lab where you want to set up a group of systems connected by a domain controller on your local host, so you can choose host only networking. I'm going to choose the very same one, so let's proceed. Then keep it default, keep here default as well. Choose new virtual disk, then specify a good size, preferably keep it at least 60 gigs of space for C drive of your virtual machine, because increasing the space in later stage, it is a big headache. Choose this option, store virtual disk as a single file, and then keep this disk name as it is. Otherwise you can even modify it, but that won't make any difference, so let's keep that way. And then finish. So this is how you create your virtual machines. And if you want to know where you have saved your virtual machines later, you can check this virtual machine details. Here you see that your virtual machine is switched off right now. Configuration file is saved in this VMX file, which is under the same name as your virtual machine. Like my virtual machine name is SQL-end user. So the configuration file would be SQL-end user.vmx. So So I hope this tutorial has been informative for you. Thank you for watching this video.